slower car that Frenier will put a lap down into three. O'Neill works his way around the 56 as well. Continues to run a half car to a car length off the back of the 93. Bob Dragoon ripping back to the pits. He is just going to make it. Lonnie River is third and trying to close in. Lance Rashoy fourth. And again, Rick Hart, Cody Kilbert, Nick Hewitt, Kenny Dooley, Robert Gordon. If little Joe Daniels is on the lead lap, he is up to 10th. I'm not sure if he is. Keith O'Neill had a peek to the inside of Chris Frenier that time in a turn number two, but it wasn't there. Frenier was able to hold him off. Laps are winding down for Keith O'Neill. Really working that car hard, trying to get to the point. Five laps to go. Next time by, it'll be five to go for Chris Frenier. Coming up on some slower traffic, this could get a little tricky with some slower cars right in front. A black flag, the 36. Frenier around the 29 of two. Keith O'Neill is here, also trying to go around Pugh. He will. Now Lonnie Rivers. But Frenier has opened up about a five-car length cushion. Plate for Chris Frenier to run it side by side. Where's the leader going to go? Threading the needle on the front stretch. Karen was on the inside. Sawyer, the 28, was on the outside. And Frenier was able to thread the needle to get through. And now Chris Frenier has pulled away from Keith O'Neill. O'Neill has really worked that car hard, and I think it's going away on him now. Open track again for Frenier and O'Neill. The white flag this time for Chris Frenier. Final time around for Chris Frenier, looking for his first win of the season in the number 93. He eases his way into turn three. Slower car in front. Look to the outside, checkered flag for Chris Frenier. Keith O'Neill second. Third to Lonnie Rivers. Lance Rathboy fourth. Fifth is going to be Rick Hart. Sixth, Nick Haywood. Seventh, Cody Kilburn. Then Little Joe, Kenny Dewey, Randy Ledoux, and Mike Chris all in the mix for spots just inside the top 10 and just outside the top 10. But
waiting for Chris to get out of his car, his first win of the season, as he was able to work his way pretty quickly to the front and then held off Keith O'Neill. Keith was really on his back bumper there for several laps, but in the later stages of the race, Chris was able to pull away. All right, everybody, have a nice round of applause for Chris Frenier, the number 93, his first win. Chris, congratulations. You work your way to the front pretty quick in the race. And then in the middle stages, Keith O'Neill was really hanging just off your back bumper. But then in the later stages of the race, you were able to pull away and just had to be worried about the lap traffic. Tell us about your race.
Well, actually, lap traffic seemed to work in my favor a little bit. He seemed to be caught up a little more, and I was able to get around him quicker. But I seen an opening in about the second lap, and I said, I got to go. I love the outside anyways, and I made it stick, and here we are.
4 or 5 weeks into the season, you had some problems with the car, but it has to feel pretty good to put everything back together and end up here in victory lane with a win.
Oh, yeah. The second week of the season, we had to build a whole new motor. This feels awesome. I got a lot of people I got to thank. Days All my other sponsors, Egglefield Ford. I got to thank Lonnie Rivers. He's helped me out quite a bit this year. And another buddy of mine, Dennis Santor. We had to put a transmission in the car Thursday. So without them, I wouldn't be here. And I really got to thank my mom, my dad, and my wife, and all my crew.
All the work pays off tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Chris Friend here, everybody. His first win of the 2008 racing season.
We are back to green. And a quick start on the outside sends Gilligan to the lead up the back stretch. Josh Terry back to second. Josh Blake runs third. Josh Laporte is fourth. Speedy now to the fifth spot in the 03. Josh Terry doing a good job sticking right with Gilligan. He had his nose right on the back of the SS Minnow as they headed up the backstretch. This time by, they'll complete lap number 10, 5 to go. Top two cars have opened up a gap on the 03 of Speedy Brissett. Speedy is now to third. Blake back to fourth. Laporte is fifth. Wade Whitney, 6th, Chad Collins, 7th, Jason Blondo's 8th, Malcolm Woodward, 9th, and the McClatchy 70 runs in the top 10 in that 10th spot. Speedy Brissett trying to close the gap on the top two cars. He's opened up ground on the 4th place car of Josh Laporte. Speedy continuing to close in on Randy Martin and Josh Terry. But the laps are winding down. This time it'll be just 2 to go. Look out, Wade Whitney's 24 goes around. Refires, but we'll have a caution.
Oh, just what the speedster ordered.
It was just 1 week ago that the 02 and the 24 got together and discussed it over on pit road. Try the outside of Josh Terry as Randy Martin had a real good restart. He opened up distance on the second place car. Speedy now has second. Terry back to third. Laporte is fourth. Woodward is fifth. One to go. Speedy Brissett trying to run down Gilligan, but he is running out of time. Brissett gets as close as the back bumper, looks to the outside, they come off turn 4, Martin will win it by a car length. Brissett second, Terry third, Laporte fourth, Woodward gets the fifth spot in the 46.
That makes a half dozen for Randy Martin, his sixth win of the season. Out of the car, coming over to this side so we can get a word with him. Nice job by Josh Terry in the 43. Speedy was closing quickly there down the stretch. And Randy first, let's talk about the restart. I think that really is what played into your hands, that last restart. You were able to anticipate and really jumped out to about a 5 or 6 car length advantage on that last restart. And that might have been the saving grace.
Yeah, coming off the corner, he was kind of hesitant, and I just gave it all she had and held it to the...
Win number 6 for you, and again, this comes after putting a lot of work back into this car after a few weeks back. Pretty bad wreck up there in turn number 2, so this season really has been just a tremendous success for you across the board.
Yeah, definitely. I'd like to thank my wife, Amanda, and my son, Alex, for all the support. Without them, I couldn't do it.
How about driving tonight in the Renegade division? Did you have fun?
I had fun. It was a lot different. A lot of good competitors in that class, and just... they know how to hold the line.
Well, you've won more races now than anybody in all the divisions here. 6th win. Congratulations.
Thank you. Have a good night.
All right, Randy Martin gets the win tonight.
Rick Doner, 5 to go to try to close in on your leader. He's got some gaining to do to move in on those top two cars. There'll be 3 to go this time by for Justin Doner. Rick Doner has closed that gap to 3 car lengths. Third in the 5, but he's got a challenge from Bill Twain, 69. Those two cars battle for the number 3 spot. 2 to go this time by. Again up the backstretch. Justin Doner trying to get by that 102, which may be C.J. LeVere. Flag is out, and Rick Doner is not going to have time to run down Justin Doner. Off turn 4 the final time. Here come the checkers, and here come the Doners. Justin first, Rick second, Bobby LeVere will get third, Billy Twaits fourth, and fifth spot will go to Jeff McCormick in the 17.
Congratulations, you get the win tonight, and you did a lot of your work on the outside. Talk about how hooked up this car was for you.
Oh yeah, she come right together tonight. It was hooked up on the outside, passing cars, I loved it.
Well, you made a 3-wide move, working to the outside, trying to get to the front, and you were able to do that. What's the difference tonight? Did you do anything different to the car over the course of the week?
No, I haven't. It's just come together tonight. It's been coming together the last couple of weeks. Just finally got a chance to get up here.
Well, congratulations. Nice job getting the win tonight.
Thank you.
All right.
That's going to wrap up Motorsports Magazine for this evening. We thank you for joining us on Hometown Cable as well as www.plattsburgh.com. Rob, some exciting moments tonight and some long moments tonight.
Well, the modified division, Leon Gagne was able to get by Mike Riel, two racing veterans that have run on a lot of local racetracks and on the dirt for a long time. They race together a lot, and Leon was able to work around Mike with about 5 laps to go in that race. A real exciting modified race, and very popular, of course, when Leon Gagne pulls into victory lane, as he did tonight.
Win number 2 in the season in the sportsman division for Tyler Terry, and you interviewed him in victory lane, and he said the brakes went out on the first lap.
Well, fortunately, though, for him, I think he was able to race out to a pretty good cushion in the closing stages of that race, and that allowed him to find the right line that still allowed him to maximize the speed that he was getting from that car, in spite of the fact that the brakes were out. Another good point night as well for Buck O'Branham, who is in search of his, in pursuit of his first track championship of the 25-year career that he has in auto racing, and I think he's well on his way to getting it.
Well, we talked about the good. Now, perhaps the bad would be that Renegade race, where it was very roughly run on the track, and afterwards, Rob, over in the garage area, a double disqualification, both the first and second place cars disqualified.
See that a lot from that division. That division is usually one of the cleanest, a lot of respect and parity in that class, but tonight, for whatever reason, there was a lot of bumping and banging, a lot of yellows, not a lot of flow to that race as there usually is, and as you mentioned, a double disqualification. Both the first and second place drivers ended up being disqualified, and the win was inherited over in Tech by Lonnie Rivers. That's his 3rd win of the year, and it also pushes him perhaps a little bit closer to the top of the points.
Speaking of the top of the points, with his 6th victory tonight, Randy Martin puts about a stranglehold on the Bomber Track Championship.
More wins than anybody in all the divisions here at Airborne, a half dozen strong now for Randy Martin, and He really has set himself up in a perfect spot. It would almost be impossible. He can almost not even show up for several events and still end up with a track title.
And by virtue of his second place finish in the Napa Warrior Division, we're going to have a new points leader when we go to next week.
Looks like Rick Doner is going to become the points leader. Just 11-point gap coming into tonight's racing action. And unofficially, we had Butch Lemire somewhere around the ninth spot, and with Rick Doner finishing second, that's about a 16-point pickup. So it looks like it might be a small lead going into next week for Rick Doner.
You're not going to be with us here in person. We're going to see you on videotape with some interviews next week, but we're going to be sending you on assignment to north of the border to work on your French.
Actually, I'm going west of the border, and I'll be taking in some baseball action in Toronto. Of course, to see the Red Sox, tickets are so tough. You have to go to the road parks to see the Red Sox play, so we're going to Toronto.
So it's next Saturday night, Motorsports Magazine from the Airborne Speedway without Rob Knowles. Stay tuned. Until then, I'm Rick Knowles for Rob. Have a good night, everybody.